So I want to use the next, I guess, example of a stock that's going the opposite direction. That's Cisco today, after reporting a revenue miss, weaker than expected guidance as well. And offer the question, like, why would you spend money in a stock like this when you can pay up probably a little more than you want for almost tried and true guaranteed growth, like NVIDIA? Let's bring in Jim Labenthal, ask him that very question, because he does join us now. He owns the stock. What's the answer, my man? Why bother?
Yeah, listen, I'm going to answer the question. It's the right question to ask. I'm going to answer it in a framework. I look at what's happening to Cisco today, and I ask myself, is this a repeat of what happened with Intel? Okay, because Intel had actually outperformed the S&P 500 for many years, and then it had a series of operational missteps, and that outperformance dwindled and became underperformance, and there was a lot of regret when I sold Intel. I don't think that's the case here in Cisco. I think this is a buying opportunity, and the reason why is very simple. The stock is off so much today because of the guidance going forward. The guidance going forward is about 1.5% below where consensus was on a revenue basis, and it's all because of the supply chain. That is the epitome of a temporary factor, as opposed to a more trenchant permanent factor like Intel's operational results. So I look at a company where demand is there. There's no question that the demand is there. There's reason to believe that the demand will not only be there, but expand with infrastructure and with capital expenditures that are coming because corporate profitability is high. The demand is there. They just ran into a supply chain problem. They're the latest victim of that. Been plenty of victims of that this year. And what you have to do is just wait this out if you're in it. This is not a time to sell it. It is a time to buy it. But to be fair and to be as honest and accurate as I can, this is probably something that's going to be flat in the 50s for the next 3 to 6 months.
Wow, that's really optimistic for the people who are currently holding it like you. I mean, I feel like I want to bundle this stock with, let's say, an Intel and IBM, for example, as you kind of look at.
No, so, well, well,
hold on. Well, let me just listen to what listen to where I'm going. Listen to where I'm going. Where you could put it in a basket of so much has to go right stocks for them to really perform well. And that's where I feel like we're at, with so much has to go right for Cisco to take off, and so much has to go right now for Intel to take off, and so much about IBM's strategy has to go right. Whereas you look at the other stocks that are really taking off, it's AMD, it's NVIDIA, it's Microsoft, it's Apple, it's the other stocks like that. What do you make of that?
So, Scott, there's really two parts, at least as I heard it, to what you just said. Okay, one is the comparison to Intel and IBM, and I don't see the comparison there. I see very long-term business model problems with IBM and Intel that I just don't see with Cisco. I see a temporary supply chain issue with Cisco. But you raise a very good point. When you compare this to AMD or an NVIDIA, obviously it looks terrible. I would submit to you, however, that just about any stock in the world is going to look terrible when you compare it to NVIDIA. And that's maybe not the metric, definitely not the metric that I would use. I put together a portfolio of stocks. I've got some high-flying, shoot-the-lights-out stocks. Qualcomm, for instance, is just one. But I've got others that I'm looking to be my steady eddy returners, as Cisco, frankly, has over the last 10 years. It has performed, including its dividend, just above the S&P 500. It's had some good years, some bad years. But as long as that demand is intact, which I believe it is, and as long as this is a short-term supply chain issue, which, again, I believe it is, then it will continue to be a slight outperform to the S&P 500. I cannot compare it to NVIDIA. That's just not a realistic comparison for Cisco or, frankly, any other company, because NVIDIA is incredible. So certainly on a day like today, it looks crummy on an absolute and relative basis. But on an absolute
today,
basis, it's
just today.
And relative. Just NVIDIA, I just can't play that game.